Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is Web 3.0, also commonly called as Web 3. Well, the talk of Web 3.0, aka semantic web, has been around for over a decade. But when will it be finally implemented? What is Web 3.0 anyway? And how does it affect an average internet user? That's a lot of questions. And to answer these, we would first need to understand what Web 1.0 and Web 2.0 is. So, let's first understand them. Firstly, what is Web 1.0? Well, Web 1.0 was the first generation of World Wide Web and existed from early 1990 to around 2004. During this stage, most of the websites were static. These websites were created by businesses and consumed by users like you and me. In this, nothing was responsive, meaning everything was developed for desktops. Styles for presentation were basic, and when it came to security, all the practices, if any, were limited. Further, there was no interaction between users and the content that was created. No followers, no comments, no likes, everything was read-only. And what's even more surprising is the fact that most of the users at this time most likely didn't even have a home computer. If you want to experience some of the websites from this era, then look for the sites like fogcam.org and a few others which I've mentioned in the description below. Next, what is Web 2.0? Well, Web 2.0 is the current second generation of World Wide Web. A large amount of content is user-generated, for example, social media content, blogs, vlogs, etc. Most of this data is controlled and monetized by large companies like Google and Meta, which is also known as Facebook. Here, finally, the web is no longer read-only. Now, people can talk to each other when they are in different continents. People can collaborate, share information, share photos, buy and sell products or services, and so much more every day. There have been a lot of great things that have come out of Web 2.0, but still, it's not perfect. How, you ask? Well, the current web still has some limitations, and one of the biggest issues with Web 2.0 is security. With advancement of web technologies, security vulnerabilities and hacks have also made their upgrade. We all have heard millions of dollars being stolen from big MNCs digitally, and in many cases, average users like you and me taking a toll too. Further, another major limitation of Web 2.0 is that it has lost one of its core values, which is decentralization. The internet is now dominated by Google, Facebook, Amazon, and a few other giant companies. Originally, the internet was meant to provide everyone with equal access to data and to communicate. Instead, these large corporations have now been collecting user data and exploiting it for their monetary benefits. And now that you've got the understanding of Web 1.0 and Web 2.0, let's understand what Web 3.0 is. Well, firstly, the switch from Web 2.0 to Web 3.0 means a big change for everyday users and developers on the internet. To define it, Web 3.0 is the latest generation of World Wide Web and its focus on decentralization. Web 3.0 applications and services would increasingly be powered by blockchains, crypto assets, both fungible and non-fungible, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and metaverses. What's best about it is the fact that Web 3.0 is expected to provide personalized content and also enable people to be in control of their own data. They will be able to control who, if anyone, profits off them and their information. Further, instead of handing over your email and password to a large company, you would be able to log in securely and anonymously all over the internet without being tracked using an internet identity. Here, you can understand this internet identity as a smart contract for your data. It will allow you to authenticate with an identity anchor. Here, an identity anchor could be a security key or facial recognition. By logging in this way, it makes it much harder for hackers, since there isn't one place, like a company's database, where all of your data is stored. And further, this implies more safety and control for everyday internet users. Next, let's talk about Web 3.0's governance. By nature, Web 3.0 is permissionless, meaning that everyone and anyone can participate in the governance of the internet. Definity, a not-for-profit organization, is developing a technology for internet computer blockchain that promotes Network Nervous System, or NNS, as a mode of governance for Web 3.0. It describes a Network Nervous System, or NNS, as open algorithmic system governing the internet computer blockchain. Definity further describes how one can participate in governance of Web3 and states that anyone can participate by staking ICP tokens into one or more neurons. These neurons can submit proposals and decide to adopt or reject them. In addition, the NNS implements liquid democracy, wherein neurons can follow other neurons in form of a delegate voting power. And now that you know the fundamentals of Web 3.0, let's finally understand why Web3 matters. Well, Web 3.0 will affect everyone who uses the internet on a day-to-day basis. This means that everyday users, developers, small businesses, giant companies, governments, etc. will be affected by Web 3.0. And Web3 matters because it provides us with the following. Number 1. Better security from hackers. Number 2. Privacy rights. Number 3. Users' control over their data. Number 4. Faster and more efficient operations. Number 5. It is more adaptable to changes. Number 6. New businesses can and will emerge out of this technology. And number 7. Lastly, as it will be decentralized and will offer user-centric control, one or two large organizations or companies won't own everything. In summary, one can easily claim that Web 3.0 is the next progressive evolution of the web and will change how we interact with the internet in ways we can't even imagine right now. Lastly, examples of Web 3.0 applications are Wolfram Alpha and Apple's Siri, which can summarize large amount of information into knowledge and useful actions for people. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.